I'm a medical oncologist. I specialize in bone marrow and blood cancers, as well as bone marrow transplant. When we see a patient for the first time, often this is the first time they've heard that they have cancer. And so the first thing is we make sure they have as much time as they need. Our appointments with me are scheduled so that if I need to spend extra time, we have the time to do that, to talk about the diagnosis, for them to start to meet some of the members of our team. What we do requires a lot of people. It's not just the physicians, but we have social workers, we have nurse practitioners, we have nurse coordinators, pharmacists, dietitians. They're all part of our team. And so on the first visit, most of our patients start to meet some of those team members. The way medicine has changed at Siteman Cancer Center is that, you know, diseases are not just lumped together. A disease like leukemia, we know a lot more about it than we used to in terms of the genetics that drive how the leukemia will behave, as well as what our therapies are going to be. And so someone who looks on the internet and sees leukemia comes in sometimes with feeling that they might have an incurable disease or a disease that has limited therapies, and we, you know, try to reassure them that we're going to customize our therapy to the details that we know about their disease. Hopefully, with most of our therapies that we have for blood cancers, we eventually can cure the patients and then get them back to the life that they had. Now, the treatments may take a long time to get someone there, but our expectation is that most people will get back to the life that they had before and doing the things they want to do. My goal is to not only treat the cancer, but we're treating the patient, we're treating the family. If someone was a cyclist or someone's a hiker, we want to get them back doing those things once their treatment is done. We see people for years after their diagnosis, and what's rewarding is that we spend a lot of our time in patient follow-ups talking not about the medical things anymore, but talking about what's changed in their life. I hear about people who have grandchildren, people whose children they thought they might not see graduate college or graduate high school, and they're getting to those life-changing events. And so that's what helps keep us going in this field.